Hello viewers, this is Manash welcoming you to the series You the Oracle Expert, your one-stop shop to learn and practice Oracle Database Administration and Unix with hands-on experiments using Oracle VirtualBox virtual machines. Build your knowledge base, confidence, and make your way to be an expert Oracle DBA. In day-to-day activities of a DBA, blocking lock is a common type of performance issues that is encountered. So today, we are going to learn how to detect a blocking lock using SQL Plus. I'm using 3 SQL Plus sessions with system user to create the blocking lock situation, and one session using Toad with sys user to capture the blocking lock related statistics. All the SQL statements that I'm using in this sys session can be found in a text file in my Google Drive, and I have shared the link to that file in the description of this video below. And I have already created one test table in the system user schema. The name of the table is test log with 2 columns. The first column named n that stores the numerical values, and the second column called s that stores character values. And I have already inserted 3 records to that table, and these are the 3 rows, 1a, 2b and 3c. And this second SQL statement we are using to get the information about all these 3 sessions established using system user, and the first session with the SID 76, the second one with 90, and the third one with 288. Now let's execute a simple DML or update statement in the first SQL session, then second and third, and we'll create a situation where the second and the third session will be waiting for the first session to release the lock on the test log table. And this update statement will be update test log set n equals to 4, where n equals to 3. And we'll execute a similar statement in the second session, but to set the value of the n to a different value. See, it's 5, but this session is also targeting the same row, so it goes to a hung state because the first session has not yet released the lock on the same row. Now we'll execute a similar statement, but setting a value of n to say 6. And this session is eventually going to a hung state or a waiting state, because in the queue of sessions requesting the lock, the first session already got the lock and it has not completed the transaction, so it's still holding the lock. The second session is waiting for the first session to release the lock and it is in a waiting state, and the third session is waiting for the second session to complete its transaction, and in the queue of waiters, it is in the second position. Now, if we try to extract the session information of all these 3 sessions using the same SQL statement, in the wait event or the event column, we'll be able to see that the second and the third session is assigned with NQTX row lock contention. And we can see that these 2 sessions are having this wait event. Now, this is a blocking lock situation. Until and unless the first session completes the transaction by either rolling back or committing the transaction, these 2 sessions will continue to wait. And this is a situation we often encounter in our database systems that creates severe performance issues with blocking lock contention. Now we'll go ahead and extract the blocking lock related statistics using this sys session from the database. Firstly, to detect blocking lock issues or blocking sessions using SQL Plus, we have a few different views in Oracle to get different pieces of information about locks, which are v$lock, v$locked object, v$session, DBA blockers, DBA waiters, etc. And I am using these views in my SQL statements. So the first one, it is using the v$lock, this particular view, and also in a subquery, the same view is being used. And this is the most simplest of all SQL statements to extract the blocking lock situation, where It will give us which session is holding the lock and what is the lock ID, lock mode, and what type of lock it is and which sessions are waiting. For example, in our case, the first session is the holder or the blocking session, and the next two sessions are waiters with SID 288 and 90. And the first one has a SID 76. Now the second SQL statement to extract the blocking lock related statistics is a little complicated, and it is joining multiple views from the views that I just mentioned, like DBA blockers, DBA waiters, V$locked object, DBA objects, etc. And this will give us a lot of information about the holding session and the waiting sessions, like the holding session SID serial number, the user holding the lock, what is the lock type, what is the mode, which machine the sessions are established, and using what module, and also the waiting sessions SID and serial number, and what is the username used by those sessions, and what is the object ID of the table getting locked here, and the name of the object. So this is our test table with a name test lock. And now the third SQL statement that I am using here is useful in single instance as well as RAG databases, and it gives us all the information about what instance ID, SID and serial number of the blocking and waiting sessions. Because in a RAG database, the blocking session come from one instance and the waiting sessions can come from different instances. So it is important to identify which instance the sessions coming from. And if you see, the first column is giving us the instance ID, SID and serial number separated by some columns here, what session it is blocking and for how many minutes. For example, we can see that the session with SID 76 here is blocking the other two sessions with SID 288 and 90, and their serial numbers are also there. And this session with SID 76 is blocking the other two sessions for 9 minutes. So this is a very useful information, because this will help us decide whether we should kill this session that is blocking the other sessions, or we should leave it to run for another couple of minutes. In a RAG environment, it is important to know about the instance ID from which the blocking sessions or the waiting sessions are coming. However, if you want, you can also modify the first two SQL statements to work in a RAG environment. Now, this is how we can use SQL statements to detect the blocking lock situation in a database. The next tutorial will be on how to detect blocking sessions using OEM. So viewers, I hope you enjoyed the video and found it useful. Please hit the like button if you liked it and subscribe to my channel so you won't miss an episode in this series for the Oracle DBAs or similar educational videos that I am uploading every week.